welcome to the DeHart House podcast, episode 4. Yay! My name is Alicia, and you can find me on Ravelry as AlidiaKnits2, on Instagram as AlidiaKnits2, and in my Etsy shop at DeHart House Creations. So today is Friday, March 3rd. So February is over. I know February is only 28 days, sometimes 29, but boy, those 2 days just seem to make a huge difference. Like, 2 days is not a lot of time when you think about knitting, and especially if they're work days for me. But boy, I found it really challenging to complete my February socks. So, yeah. I did it. And I have those to show to you today. I guess I should show you my finished object first before I show you what I'm working on. So finished objects. Oh, P.S. I did wait until later in the day to record this, hoping that the natural light will help with the lighting issues that I was having with showing yarn colors. If this didn't resolve that problem, I will insert pictures like I did last time. Fingers crossed I don't have to do that this time. Anyway, finished objects. I finished my February socks, thank God, in February. So there are a lot of year-long knit-alongs. That's too many longs. Year-long knit-alongs about making socks all year long. Now, I'm kind of new to sock knitting, so that seemed like a pretty big undertaking for me, and I am 2 for 2. January, I made my pair of socks, and now February. So I finished my pair of celestial colors socks, and I have a project page on Ravelry. Okay, so far I'm liking the way the colors are showing up better than last time. So I knit this pair. I started this pair on February 2nd, and I finished them on February 27th. That took a while. I'm pretty new to sock knitting, so I guess that's not that long for, it's like 2 weeks for a pair of socks. I don't know, it just seemed to drag on for me, so I'm so happy I finished them. I knit them cuff down, 2x2 ribbing for 20 rounds, and for this pair I consulted Hermione's Everyday Socks pattern. Totally messed it up. I mean, I guess not totally, but it is a free pattern on Ravelry. A lot of people have knit these beautiful socks. It's a four row repeat, and I messed up one of the rows. And I know how I messed it up. And so next time I try this pattern, I'll know better. And so I promise I'll fix it, and on my next pair. These I'm going to leave. I feel a sneeze coming on. Okay. I drank my 2 cups of coffee already this morning and 1 cup of caffeine-free tea, and it is like, ooh, I could check the time. It is noon. Turn my volume down. It is noon, so that explains why I'm hungry. I have like the worst snack ever. Okay, leftovers from our camping trip. I'm not gonna eat them while recording, as hungry as I am. But I did start them before recording. And anyway, back to my socks. Sidetracked already. Fish lips, kiss heel, standard toe. Well, my version of the standard toe. I decreased down to 12 stitches and then Kitchener stitch, so it's not quite half or a quarter, it's somewhere in between. So, as a mathematician, I could figure out the fraction, I just don't care to. So, I finished the second sock in a weekend. Yeah. Last time I had the cuff finished, I believe, and started a couple rounds of the pattern, and then the rest of the sock I did over the weekend, last weekend. So I recorded episode 3 on Friday. I didn't get it posted till we got back from our camping trip because the file conversion just took too long. Whatever, I got it up at the beginning of the week, and now it's Friday again, so I'm recording again. So we went to Padre Island National Seashore. I am in Texas, and Padre Island is in Texas on the coast of the Gulf of Mexico. I really need to study a Texas map because I'm terrible at knowing where things are located. I'm originally from Michigan, and I know Michigan like the back of my hand. Okay, that was terrible. I don't know where things are in Texas. I need to study that, especially when I ask. I teach math at a college here in town, and I ask my students where they're from, and they'll tell me some town in Texas, and I'm like, yep, don't know where that is. And then they try to tell me in relation to some of the big cities, like Houston or Dallas, and I at least know where those are, but then I get lost, so. Maybe that should be one of my goals. Learn a new Texas City location every week. We'll see. Anyway, so it was about an eight-hour drive from our home to the National Seashore. And thank you, Michael, for driving both ways so that I could knit my sock. Oh my gosh. Yeah, we left around 12:30 on Friday last week, and arrived at what we called our campsite on the beach. Yeah, 8:39. So it was dark, and we set up our tent. I knit the whole way down, so I finished the leg and started the heel on the drive down to the beach. I didn't knit at all while we were on the beach. We met up with family, and the kids had a wonderful time, my nieces and nephews, and Marjorie, my dog, she had lots of fun. We need a better way to tie her up, because someone had to be holding her on her leash, and it was tough to do anything else with my hands except hold a leash. So I didn't do any knitting on the beach, which turned out to be a blessing in disguise, because I forgot that on sandy beaches sand gets everywhere. So my knitting projects that I took with me, I took these socks that I finished, and I also took my Find Your Fade shawl, and they stayed in their bags nice and protected from all the sand. So blessing in disguise, it worked out. So we camped Friday night on the beach. It was way too windy in our tent, and it was the rain fly on top was flapping in the wind so much that we couldn't sleep. It was crazy loud, and I just kept worrying about the rainfly just totally coming loose, and then sand blowing everywhere, and oh, it was a nightmare. So, we slept in the car after Michael helped get someone out of the sand. They were driving up in a car, and they didn't have four-wheel drive, and they were pulling up close to our tent so they could ask for directions. They were trying to find a campsite in the campground, but they missed their turn for the campground, and they ended up on the beach anyway. They got stuck, so Michael helped dig out the wheel and push the car, and they hopefully found their way to their campsite. And then we decided, well, since we're up anyway, we'll just move our bed into the car. And so we have a Honda CR-V, which is a SUV, and we just folded, well, we already had the back seat folded down, and so the trunk space was bigger, so we just emptied out everything that we had left in the car into the tent, and then we moved our bedding into the car, and we slept in there, and our tent was still there when we woke up in the morning. The rainfly was still attached. I think one stake came loose in the night. So, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. That worked out. And we were able to sleep in a nice, quiet environment. So, the next day we woke up and it was still really windy, so we couldn't really start up the camp stove with the flame in confidence that it would stay lit to make coffee and breakfast. So we just drove back into, not into town per se, but just up the island to a gas station, and we got breakfast tacos and wonderful warm coffee. And breakfast tacos are not a thing I'm used to. Growing up in Michigan, it seems to be a pretty common theme down here in Texas, and they're wonderful. And so I had egg and chorizo. I have trouble rolling my R's. Chorizo, egg and chorizo with cheese, and it was wonderful. And my hot coffee with, what did I choose? Caramel macchiato creamer, and we moved our tent to a more protected area on the beach from the wind, and met up with family, and the kids went swimming, and I built our campfire with my sister-in-law Gracie, and we had a lovely time roasting hot dogs that night and having s'mores. And we woke up to an open cooler. Michael and I weren't thinking. We camp. We love to camp. And we know about bear safety. And bears recognize coolers. So you want to keep your cooler in your car, because a bear, without even smelling anything, he just sees the cooler and knows. Humans usually store food in there, so I should break into this cooler. And we thought, well, we're on the beach in Texas. There are no bears. We'll be fine. We can just we brought a fold-out card table with us, and we put the cooler underneath, and we thought, you know, it'll be fine. And we woke up, and the cooler was open, and the food was gone. And I found paw prints. We're thinking that they were foxes, and I also saw some deer tracks, and some little tiny feet, probably ground squirrels. So yeah, they just had a feast. Now, we ate most of the hot dogs and drank most of the beverages, so the only things they really got into were lunch meat for sandwiches, some vegetables I'd packed, and breakfast. So we drove back in and got more breakfast tacos for the lot of us, since we had nothing to eat for breakfast except this. For some reason, Mr. Fox did not notice the Walmart bag tied up full of chips, various mini bags of chips. And so that was totally untouched in the morning, which baffled me. They just ripped into the cooler, so we know better. And I just am kicking myself for being so irresponsible. So Michael picked up all the trash from the baggies they left behind from eating the food, so that was nice. And the cooler wasn't damaged, we just lost our breakfast, so whatever. And then we came home on Sunday, and I knit the rest of the heel, the foot of the sock, and started the toe decreases, and then that's when it got dark. We were still about an hour and a half away from home, so I totally could have finished it in the car, but once it got dark, I couldn't, you know, like, keep checking my work, if you will, and I was dropping stitches and swearing and hating knitting, and Michael told me, why don't you just stop? Why don't you just stop? You've been knitting for like 7 hours. You're tired and it's dark and you can't see. Just stop. He was right. So I stopped, and yeah, I finished the toe the next day. Not a big deal. It was still February, so busy weekend. Had lots of fun. So I digressed a lot in my finished objects section. So let me finish my finished objects section. Celestial Colors socks. On my project page in Ravelry, this is knit out of Celestial Colors, is the color name in Patton's Croix, which is a 4-ply wool yarn. And I knit these on, I put them back in their package. I'm trying to stay organized with my knitting needles. Knitter's Pride Nova Platina on the 16-inch cables. And that's good to know. 16 inches is 40 centimeters, because I was just eyeing a new pattern which asked for 40 centimeters. And these are size 1, which is a 2.25 millimeter. And the camera is not focusing. Come on. There you go. Okay, so I really love the 2 circular needle method. My favorite so far. I've tried double point needles and the 2 circular needles. So that's where I'm at with that. So, works in progress. Let me just show you what I'm currently working on before I start another row. So I finished my February socks in February. I'm 2 for 2. It is now March. So yesterday, March 2nd, apparently on the 2nd of each month I'll start my socks, I started my March socks. And you'll notice I'm knitting these a little differently this time. I'm knitting them 2 at a time, magic loop style. The needles are also size 1, 2.25 millimeter, right? 2 and a quarter millimeters. These are Chow Goo Red Lace 40-inch circular needles. And I bought these a while ago thinking, at some point I'll learn magic loop. So then I could do double points. I have enough double point needles where I could have two socks. I have enough circular needle, the two circulars, the 16 inch, to knit two socks. And now I have a 40 inch cable where I could knit two socks at a time. So hypothetically, I could have three pairs of socks going at a time. Which is more than what I need. Honestly, I think it was episode 2 where I talked about getting bogged down by all my works in progress, so being able to work 3 pairs, I think, is plenty. At least at this point in my knitting career. So, this is a different kind of yarn. This is not Patton's Croix. Whoa! I know, it's not Patton's Croix. All of my socks so far have been Patton's Croix. So I'm branching out in 2 different ways. Different yarn and different way of knitting this. On different needles. So, let me find the yarn label here. Okay. I don't know what this is called because I can't read that cursive blue nonsense. I'm sorry, but when you make a label, make it readable. Okay? Just... And my bangs that I'm trying to go out are doing weird things, so... There. So, I don't know. Online? On Lou? I'm not going to pretend to speak a different language. Anyway, the label's in German and English. And... I've actually made it a goal of mine this year to refresh on my German. I did take 2 semesters of German in my undergrad, and actually I took it with my sister, and she bought the textbook that we shared, and so I purchased the same textbook, my own copy, and I'm trying to go back through it and relearn German. So, anyway, this is 75% wool, 25% polyamide, and it's a 6-ply. I figured out. I guess, 6-fuck? I'm not swearing, I promise. Zex is 6, right? Zex-fuck? Anyway. Yeah, 6-ply. I didn't realize that when I cast these on yesterday. But I did realize it like 10 rounds in. 10 rounds on 2 socks. I wasn't gonna rip it out. It's fine. So Patton's Croix is 4-ply. This is 6-ply, so it's a thicker yarn. Come on, focus. Focus on my face. Awkward. All right. Anyway, so it's not the same. I'm not sure how to describe it. But, you know, it's bigger. So I cast on the same number of stitches as I normally do. So for myself, 64 stitches seems to be the sweet spot. I'm not sure why this isn't focusing. Thank you. So I have my January socks and my February socks. Those are literally the only socks that I've knit for myself. So Michael and I are tied at 2 pairs of socks each. So I could knit these for myself and finish his, and then we'll be 3 and 3. Okay. Anyway, I cast on 64 for myself, which seems to be fine right now. It's, I haven't really had time to wear out my socks yet, and so I may find that I need to go up or down on stitches depending how they stretch out over time. Anyway, I cast on the same number I did with 4-ply, and so it's a little bulkier, and so I was going back and forth between vanilla sock in just stockinette and getting Hermione's everyday sock correct. But due to the bulkiness, I'm just going to do this 2x2 ribbing for the whole sock, just like I'm doing with Michael's socks. So when I started knitting socks, the loop on Magic Loop is, I still haven't figured out how to like bend the cable so that it goes where I want it to go. Anyway, so I end up with the loop up, because that's just, I don't know. I'll figure it out. But so when I started knitting socks, it was partly because I was watching Grocery Girls podcast, and they do a sock talk segment, and they knit a lot of socks. Wet Coast Wools podcast was actually the first knitting podcast I had found and started watching, and Bernadette knits a lot of socks, and found more podcasts with more socks, and I said, gosh, I gotta try knitting socks. So it was partly because I wanted to try it and I wanted to see if I would like it, and part of it was because Michael and I do like to go camping and hiking for our vacations, and I thought, gosh, it'd be wonderful if I had good socks to wear in my hiking boots. I usually wear, I always wear socks in my shoes to work. You know, as a teacher, I'm standing and walking a lot, and let's be honest, my feet get sweaty, and if I don't wear socks, my shoes really stink. And the last thing I want is to be walking around my classroom and having my students go, ooh. So I wear socks, and my shoes last longer, and my feet don't stink, so that's good. But I don't necessarily want to wear my nice work socks out hiking. So I have nice black socks that I'll wear. I have some thin socks for the I have some tight high heel boots, and I can't wear thick socks in them or else they wouldn't fit. So I have thin socks specifically for those, and then I have little footy type socks to wear in my flats, and yeah, so I definitely can't wear those hiking. And then I have just store-bought socks for when I'm working out, with the thicker soles on the bottom, so my socks don't wear out as much, because I do like to run when I'm working out, and that puts a lot of wear and tear on socks. And so, yeah, that's that. I need to find boots. I've been wanting to buy boots that are flats, that aren't the high heel boot. Gosh, I wish I had looked up this terminology beforehand. But I go between flats and these high heel boots that only cover my ankle. They don't like go up to my knee or anything. And usually I'll wear my dress pants so they go over the outside of the boot. Anyway, I would really love to have some flat boots as well that come up higher, like mid-calf or just below the knee, and then those would be perfect for, I'd like to get them a little thicker around the leg so I have room to wear my knitted socks. Maybe not this pair because they're bulky, but I say bulk. They're not that much bulkier, but it was enough that I noticed, and I'm sort of new, not gonna lie. I'm somewhat new to sock knitting, so. And I've only knit socks with one kind of yarn. So, anyway. So, my next work in progress that I'd like to talk about is I'll skip Michael's socks because I only added 5 rounds. I haven't even made it to the heel yet, so. Oh my gosh, 6 plies. I make sure I get them all on the needle. Anyway, not much progress has been made. I have this past week been working on, well, these I started yesterday. I'm so proud of myself for getting this far. And my Find Your Fade shawl. So, excuse me. This is living in a DeHart House Creations sweater size bag with a Christmas design. Last time I was transitioning between color number 3 and color number 4, and I have finished that transition, and now I just have color 4 attached. And this is super exciting. The point that I'm at, and I'll show you that in a bit. I'll just give you the big overview here. And yes, right side is facing you. So the owl is, where I was last time in the transition between the green and this new color, which is Knit Picks Hawthorne Vancouver. So I've made it this far, which is pretty good. So I went through the transition, I went through the garter, I'm in the lace, which is why I'm not working on this while podcasting, because with the lace, I definitely have to count and remember what the heck I'm doing and consult the pattern so I don't mess up again. Because I'm now, when you finish the transition from color 3 to color 4, you stop increasing, thank God. I mean, I love how massive this is going to be, but there definitely comes a point where it's like, can I stop increasing already? Like, when am I ever gonna finish this? So, yay! So, this is a side where, right, I stopped increasing, and so I'm getting this nice the corner. It's really exciting to see this growing. Color number 5 is not too far off in the future. So yeah, I'm super, super excited about this. So there's the ball. So the light blue is really dominant, especially on camera. And it is a huge pop of color compared to the purples and the greens. But yeah, since my next color is blue, I guess that's okay. Not exactly this blue. But yay! So, Find Your Fade, color 4 out of 7. I'm super happy. Yeah, I guess I could transition into goals. Last week, my goal was to finish my second sock within the timeline of February. And I did it. So, yay, I met my goal. This week, my goal is to only work on my March socks and my Find Your Fade. because I really want to finish both of these projects this month. The other works in progress that I have going have seen no love, because I am participating in winter camp and I really want to get those points and maybe win some cool prizes. And that means I have to finish stuff to get points. And other than socks, I have some pretty big projects on the needles. I have a cardigan, I have a blanket, I have the Find Your Fade shawl. Yeah. Yeah. So, I'm looking around seeing if there's anything else. Anyway. So, that's my goal for the next week. We'll see if I can meet that goal by only working on these two things. It's going to be tough to resist casting on something new. Last time in episode 3, I showed you all of these lovely yarns behind me that I got in. And I just keep, every time I look in here, I keep looking at them like, merino. I can knit myself some merino nylon socks. Other than Patton's Croix or this 6-ply yarn. Which, by the way, where'd I put that label? Oh, there it is. So the label's in German and English, and then it says, made in Italy. So, not really sure where this yarn comes from. Not here, so. Ugh, I find that funny, but yeah. 150 grams for $12. So that was a steal at my local yarn shop. So, somewhat local yarn shop. It's within 45 minutes of my house. Anyway, I definitely want to go back the next time we go into Midland. I am stopping in there and getting something. So, but not this weekend. I feel like I messed up. Oh, brother. No, I didn't. I just knit more than I thought I did. Wow. Okay. So that concludes works in progress. And goals. So next I'll talk about shop update. So DeHart House Creations on Etsy. I am in the process of making more bags, so it has taken me a while to get around to it, but I finally have worked up this lovely fabric with this girl and her fox, and they both have balloons. And I have a coordinating green interior to match her outfit. And of course the rings and clips and straps and handles and whips and chains and, no, just kidding. No whips and chains. But a detachable handle you could turn it into a zipper pull if you wanted. Anyway, I made the sock size bag yesterday, and this weekend I'll be making the sweater size and the notions size. I've already cut the fabric out. I just need to assemble the bags and get everything posted in the shop. So that is happening. And let's see what else. I'm trying not to give myself too many goals this weekend for shop updates, because I promised Michael that I would help him in his wood shop if he wanted help. So I may end up holding you know, boards of wood while he cuts them or glues them or stains them or whatever. So, I may or may not get to knit while making sure he doesn't cut off a finger. or it may be more hands-on help. So I'm trying not to be too ambitious, because if I say I want to get X, Y, and Z done this weekend and I don't get them done, I will feel disappointed. And if I just don't make those goals, then it's not a big deal. Yeah, so that's it for shop update. I promise I'll be better. I got all my zippers in, and I have tidied up my craft room a little bit more so that it's easier to come in and just start working. I've been pretty bad about folding up my scraps of fabric and actually putting them in the scrap box. I've just been leaving them out. So when I come in, it just looks messy. It's nothing big, it's just some scraps here and there, and I misplaced the scissors and things like that, and it's just like, ugh, I don't want to deal with it, I'll just knit some socks. So, anyway, that's that. Let's see, what else did I have on my show notes? I'm just checking my tablet. Yes, I need to put out an apology to Yarn Cafe Creations. So, Christy at Yarn Cafe Creations, I'm so sorry. Last episode I mentioned going to your shop and trying to buy yarn, and the price changed at the checkout. So, one price was listed on the list of items, and a different price was listed at checkout, and I figured out why. It's nothing that you did. It was totally my fault. My settings were incorrect in Etsy. So on your profile in Etsy, you can set settings about where you're located and your default currency, and those were the things that were wrong for me. SGD is Singapore dollar, not standard ground domestic or super great deal. Singapore dollar. Yeah, Etsy thought I was in Singapore. So what happened is I'm shopping on my Etsy app, and I'm like, oh yeah, look at that price, that's awesome. And all that's showing up in US dollars. And then I get to the checkout and it's converting it to Singapore dollars for me, thinking, here, this is how much you're going to pay in your currency. And I was like, why is it so much more? This is ridiculous. Yep, my bad. So, Christy, I just want to say I'm so sorry. It was totally my fault. I fixed it and ordered some yarn. So, thank you. I ordered a skein of yarn with a coordinating mini, and won't tell you what it is. I will show you when I get it. So I'm excited and so grateful. She really does have wonderful prices. So check her out if you can. Yarn Cafe Creations on Etsy. And yeah. Let's see. Running. I haven't been as good about running this week as I should be, but I'm getting sort of caught up at work and caught up with knitting and caught up with shop stuff. Anyway, this weekend is all about catching up, because last weekend we went camping, the weekend before that we tried to go camping, which still involved driving to a place and looking at campgrounds and driving home. So it still ate up a bunch of time, even though we didn't get to go camping. Anyway, so this weekend is all about getting caught up so that can relax. Anyway, So running, I ran a mile yesterday, and that's it. That's all I've done this week for running. I got a new copy of Runner's World in the mail yesterday as well. Yeah, yesterday was pretty awesome. I don't know what it was about yesterday, but I felt really good, and I felt like, let's do this, let's get this done, which was perfect. So, yesterday also happened to be homecoming on campus, so I went out to support our baseball team, our women's and men's basketball teams, and I didn't get to make it to the play that was happening last night, but awesome job, guys. I heard wonderful things. So it was homecoming, there were activities, lots of events, so I went out and, excuse me, knit socks and rooted for our teams. So I also found time to run a mile and write some exams and set up some homework and things like that with work and take Marjorie for a walk. And it was just like the most productive day I've had in a while. So yeah, I'm coming into the weekend with a go get 'em attitude, and that's what I'm going to do. So when I'm finished recording and editing and posting this video, I'm going to be going out there and getting them. So hopefully next week I can tell you about all the wonderful things I've accomplished. Yeah, let's see. Magic loop. I got it. I think I got it. Someone else is trying Magic Loop for the first time too, with two at a time. I believe her name is Loose Pages on Instagram, and I commented on that, and she's also excited about this process, and I agree, it was rough to start. The first round of any knitting project is my least favorite round. It just takes me so long to knit through and knit and purl and whatever, just to get through that first round. Partly because you can't see the pattern, you can't check to make sure you're in the right spot. It's a pain. So I really like with two at a time. I've done the worst part already for both socks, so that's awesome. But she did say, we'll see how it is when we get to the heel. Yeah, we'll see. Anyway, I don't think it's that bad. And if it gets that bad, I do have two circular needles that are empty, if I need to swap over. So, yeah. What else did I want to talk about? Anything? I don't know. Oh, I have to say, I love my craft room, and I love having the yarn in the background for filming. I'm wondering if maybe this just isn't the best place in my house to record because of the lighting. I don't know. I'm experimenting. It's only episode 4, right? So, okay. Yeah. So it is March. I guess I'll just add this in as a last tidbit. Are you keeping up with your New Year's resolutions? Whatever they may be. My New Year's resolutions, I'll just tell you a few. I tend to make a lot just in the different categories of my life and my interests. So, Last year, I wanted to run 2 5Ks and I did it. This year, I want to run a 10K or a half marathon, and I'm doing some running, so I'm getting there. It's not where I as much running as I'd like to be doing, but my yarn's all twisted. But I am doing it, so that's good. I want to do the 12 pairs of socks. That's going well so far. I want to get Marjorie trained to walk on her leash appropriately so she's not pulling all the time. And she is showing improvement. Yesterday when we went for our walk, she understands back up. You need to back up. And she does it one paw at a time, but she does it. So we're getting there. I just need to work with her every day. And that's kind of the thing is just I need to be thinking about my goals often to remember. So yeah, so have you been keeping up with your New Year's resolutions? It is March. Have you fallen off the wagon already? Or are things going really well? Or maybe it's a resolution you made down the line that you should maybe start prepping for, like running a half marathon or something. Yeah, I would love to hear. So I'm going to post this question in a thread in my Ravelry group, DeHart House Podcast. And yeah, I'd love to hear if you're keeping up with your New Year's resolutions. And maybe I can scrounge up a prize or something. Yeah, I can scrounge up a prize for that. So, have you been keeping up with your New Year's resolutions so far? All right, I will sign off with that and see you guys next week. Happy knitting!